Dear students, welcome you all to this Engineering Graphics lecture series. Today we are going to discuss about introduction about projections of solids. Solid is a three-dimensional object. It is having length, breadth and width. Solids are classified into two classifications, polyhedra and solids of revolution. Under polyhedra, solids are classified into cube, tetrahedron, prisms, and pyramids. Under solids of revolution, classified into three classifications. Cylinder, cone, sphere. Cube having six square faces. Square faces 6, a number of corners 8 corners, in tetrahedron having 4 equilateral triangular faces, equilateral triangular means, triangle means all the sides are equal, triangle all the sides are equal. So number of corners, 4 corners. The topmost corner is known as vertex or apex. Corners 4. Prisms having 2 bases. Based on its shape of the base, it is named. For example, the base shape square means the prism is known as square prism. Rectangle means rectangular prism. Pentagon means pentagonal prism. Square prism. Square prism having 4 rectangular faces. Number of rectangular faces 4. Number of corners 8. An imaginary line joining the bottom base center and top base center is known as axis line. An imaginary line joining the bottom base center and top base center is known as axis line. Okay. Similarly, rectangular prism, triangular prism. Triangular prism having three triangular faces. And pentagonal prism having five triangular faces, hexagonal prism having six triangular faces. Sorry, pentagonal prism having five rectangular faces, not triangular faces, rectangular faces, and triangular prism having three rectangular faces, and hexagonal prism having six rectangular faces. Pentagonal prism okay. So in pentagonal prism having five rectangular faces. An imaginary line joining the bottom base center and top base center is known as axis line. An imaginary line joining the top base center and bottom base center is known as axis line. Axis line. Okay, in pyramids, pyramid having only one base, the topmost corner is known as vertex or apex. For example, square pyramid. In square pyramid, square pyramid in five corners available including vertex or apex. Five corners available. The topmost corner is known as vertex or apex. Four triangular faces available. Four triangular faces. Similarly, in pentagonal pyramid, five triangular faces available. And hexagonal pyramid, six triangular faces available. This edge name slant edge. Slant edge. So number of slant edges in square pyramid, four slant edges available. Number of slant edges in pentagonal pyramid, five slant edges available. In hexagonal pyramid, six slant edges available. And in hexagonal pyramid, six triangular faces available. Okay. Cylinder is obtained by rotating a rectangular plane about the fixed axis. An imaginary line joining the bottom base circumference and top base circumference is known as generators. These are generators. These generators are used to draw the diagram. Cone obtained by rotating the right angle triangle about the fixed axis. An imaginary line joining the bottom base circumference and vertex is known as generators. An imaginary line passing through the bottom base center and the top vertex is known as axis line. In sphere is obtained by rotating a semicircle about the fixed axis. Rotating a semicircle about the fixed axis. Okay, these are the basic solids in projections of solids. Next, we will discuss about what is the standard, what are the standard positions of solids in first quadrant. The position of solid based on its two reference planes, horizontal plane and vertical plane, and axis of the solid. The first one is, take a horizontal and vertical plane. HP and VP, take a cylinder. Axis of the solid, the first position, axis of the solid perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP. And second position, axis of the solid perpendicular to VP and parallel to HP. And third position, axis of the solid parallel to both HP and VP. And fourth one, axis of the solid inclined to HP and parallel to VP. Fifth position, axis of the solid inclined to VP and parallel to HP. Sixth position, axis of the solid inclined to both HP and VP. Axis perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP. Second position, axis of solid perpendicular to VP and parallel to HP. And third position, axis parallel to both HP and VP. Both HP and VP. Fourth position, axis inclined to HP and parallel to VP. Inclined to HP and parallel to VP. Okay. And fifth position, axis inclined to VP and parallel to HP. Inclined to VP and parallel to HP. Sixth position, inclined to both HP and VP. Both HP and VP. Okay. Next, we are going to discuss about what is truncated pyramid and cone. A pyramid or cone cut by a plane inclined to its base. Solids. Next is the topic. Frustum of cone or pyramid. Frustum of cone or pyramid. A cone or pyramid cut by a plane parallel to its base. The top portion removed, the remaining portion is known as frustum of cone or pyramid. For example, take a cone. It is cut by a plane parallel to its base. The top portion removed, the remaining portion is known as frustum of cone. Okay. Next heading, truncated solids. A solid, maybe a cone or pyramid or a cylinder, cut by a plane inclined to its base. The top portion removed, the remaining portion is known as truncated solid. Truncated, this cone means truncated cone, solid pyramid means truncated pyramid. Okay, these are the introduction about projections of solids. Dear students, if you like this video, share it to your friends and subscribe our channel. Thank you very much. We will meet in next video. Thank you.